where the public of Aboi were motivated and have been efficiently insisting the government to take up our priority in fulfilling the dreams and vision of Aboi to establish the administrative headquarters at Aboi. Therein, over time, we have been submitting numerous proposals and we have been a good citizen of the state of Nagaland. Therefore, we are optimistic that it shall never go in vain as being a good citizen of the state. Once again, I would like to recollect that Aboi was never established by the dreams and all the demands of the public. It was first established way back in 1955 as a base camp, where it was upgraded, the CO and then the EAC. It was the need of the government of Nagaland and government of India. Therefore, over the years and decades long historical structures are well established. And when we are also imbued with the idea that we should have a better infrastructure, administrative convenience, and economic development. Therefore, the public of Aboi is deemed fit, and we look forward that with your mighty presence over here, we shall be establishing the administrative headquarters headed by Deputy Commissioner very soon. It was way back in 1935, the landscapes of the area, as a record speaking, speaks volumes of the generous contribution of the good Lord in order to be uplifted, either economically, infrastructurally, be it in roads or in various educational institutions. We deserve the right to live a better life and to promote the tranquility and the, in every aspect of development for a good cause and to uplift the structure of the conduct in general. Sir, as you well know, Aboi is the epicenter of Bon District, and it is not just an epicenter to Bon District alone. It is a multi-junction to all the ENPO areas. And once again, drawing back to the coverage, as rightly mentioned by our additional Deputy Commissioner, Sir Jumla Mohan Soy, it covers two accessible, namely Chen and Amchanyang, and one ESG headquarters, Mopong. And it also comprises of three assembly constituencies, namely Moka, Aboi, and Tohok. And not forgetting the rightly place our brotherhood, the blood brothers of ours, Tubu. We are here to draw a curtain in saying that Tubu and Aboi, Tohok, Moka, we are rightly brothers, and we look forward that together we can achieve greater heights with the wisdom that you have in order to develop the backward area. And sir, to be precise, once again, we have 24 departments which are empowered with DBOs and 14 non-DBOs. And Aboi is very much multilingual, multi-religious, and a massive migration is in progress. And we comprises of 1,217 households alone in Aboi town. And therefore, we do not have any placement to draw a competitive line on anybody else. We are a good neighbor, good friend, and a good sister to all the brethren that we live with. Once again, drawing the population, we have 124,534 population in general. And as you well know, the prison period of all the administrative boundaries are very much closing near before 31st of December 2021. We look forward that your immediate actions and your comments in every government proposals or meetings would be very valuable and it would fulfill the whims and wishes of the people over here. And when it comes to establishing an administrative headquarters, we may be quite reluctant when it comes to description of the land and its boundaries. But to be very precise once again, the area surrounding villages are ready to provide as much as land that is required for the development of the Aboy administrative headquarters. And finally, coming back to the point, you may be well aware with the government decisions and its implementations. However, drawing back to 13 years back, the Aboy District Demand Committee initiated the proposal for establishment of administrative headquarters way back in 2008. And therein, it was placed in cabinet memo and was well discussed on 13th of December 2011 under the chairmanship of Sri former Chief Secretary Lal Thara. And it was placed at serial number 1 along with Noklak, which was placed at serial number 2. So at some point of time, we too feel deprived and our hunger for establishment and our genuine rights grow younger each day, and it is for you to make us feel older and mature in presence in the establishment of the district headquarters. And finally, coming back to the, there were times where during our insistent proposals to the government, we were often said, like the Connaught Union in general wishes to have only one district administrative headquarters. And there were even a written document which says like there would be no creation of another district within Mon District. However, on 15th of October 2021, a discussion was well placed at the Connaught Union office wherein the Connaught Union has withdrawn its letter and has proposed the government of Nagaland to create new district under Mon District for the upliftment of the people. Sir, you are well aware of the inconveniences faced by our people, be it employment, be it development, wherein we all know how Konyak is. Konyak community is a big tribe where we come under the umbrella of one deputy commissioner and one SP. However, when it comes to distribution of work, distribution of allocations of funds, and be it in the employment sector, we are always drawn in parallel with the rest of the other district headquarters. Therefore, it is a diehard chapter to look into. Therefore, I, on behalf of the public, once again pray that our dreams and aspirations we threw into our midst will never go in vain. And we remain optimistic, as you sir, that we are good citizens, as a good citizens of this state, our dreams will be fulfilled. Thank you, Tuk Nalin Pusoy.